Our homes look beautiful when elegantly accessorize them, and so does our soul require accessories for its beautification. Do you know what are these accessories? These are one's conduct amongst which feeding the poor holds utmost reward. Let's call Juveri of class 2nd to speak on the topic importance of feeding the poor.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May peace, mercy and blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be upon you all. When Allah blesses you financially, don't raise your standard of living. Instead, raise your standard of giving. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May peace, mercy and blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be upon you all. I would like to throw a light on the topic importance of feeding the poor. There is a myth which says there is not enough food for everyone to eat. But the reality is not all people have to require access to buy food. Allah says in the Holy Quran, chapter 76, verse 8 and 9, وَيُطْعِمُونَ الطَّعَامَ عَلَىٰ حُبِّهِ مِسْكِينًا وَيَتِيمًا وَأَسِيرًا إِنَّمَا نُطْعِمُكُمْ لِوَجْهِ اللَّهِ لَا نُرِيدُ مِنْكُمْ جَزَاءً وَلَا شُكُورًا. The righteous are those who feed the poor, the orphans and the captive for the love of Allah, saying, we feed you for the sake of Allah alone. We seek from you neither reward nor thanks. Nowadays, it has become a trend to spend lavishly on parties and get-togethers, inviting thousands of people and serving the best of food. But all this is not considered in sawab, as the intention is not to feed for Allah's sake, but only to show off their wealth and status. But as we all know, إِنَّمَا الْعَمَالُ بِالنِّيَّاتِ. Rewards depend on intention. Once, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam had slaughtered a sheep and distributed major portion of its meat. Then he asked his wife, Aisha radiallahu anha, is there anything left? She replied, nothing except the shoulder. Thereupon Allah Messenger said, all of it is left except shoulder. This hadith of Tirmidhi demonstrates that what is gained and what is delivered to the needy is what actually remains in terms with Allah, as opposed to the food we consume. In another hadith of Tirmidhi, Allah's Messenger said, whoever feeds a hungry believer will be fed by Allah on a day of judgment from the fruits of paradise. And whoever quenches his thirst will have his thirst quenched from the pure sealed wine of paradise. The Almighty promises us that if we train ourselves in times of ease and hardships, our sustenance will increase. Giving awakens our souls, triggers genuine concern for the well-being of others. Priority is given to feeding the poor and the needy, as that is one of the best acts in Islam. Spread peace, feed the poor. Jazakumullahu khair.
Jazakallah for enlightening us with this.